So how do you transition super beefy, beautiful carpet to a hardwood floor? What's going on? It's Michael Alter here from CarpetExpertBlueprint.com, and in this video, I'm going to share with you the exact steps necessary to transition carpet to a hardwood flooring reducer there. So we have our tack strip. We're going to set that maybe a quarter inch away from the reducer in this particular scenario. Next, I am using long nails to go ahead and really reinforce the tack strip here, because we are going to use a crab stretcher because this carpet is so beefy, a knee kicker just isn't going to cut it. So we want to reinforce it so the tack strip is in tight. It's not going to pull out, anything like that. We're going to be good to go. And when you're installing your tack strip, make sure the little tiny nails are pointing towards the threshold. And like I said, have it about a quarter inch away from it. Just work your way all the way down the threshold there. Take your time, make sure everything's getting reinforced properly so you can go ahead and really install this and make things happen. So we got our next piece of tack strip in place there. And once again, make sure those little nails are pointing towards the reducer and not away from it. Otherwise, this whole process is pointless. Then take your hammer, tap down all the little nails in the tack strip there. And once those are set into the wood floor, we're gonna get our sinker nails. Anything above an inch and a quarter, inch and a half, you're gonna be in good shape, because you wanna really make sure this is down tight to the subfloor, because nothing more aggravating than using a heavy duty stretcher, stretching it onto the tack strip, and there's so much pressure that it yanks the tack strip right out. And then you have to go back to square one and start all over again. So we're gonna go ahead and reinforce every bit of this strip to make sure it's nice and secure to that tight, and it's gonna hold up for our stretch. Remove that existing padding. We're gonna get that right out of our way because it is not necessary whatsoever. Pull that out. We're gonna double check all the tack strip just to make sure it's good to go, because believe me, it's aggravating when it gets pulled back out by the stretcher there. But now we have our last nail set in. Let's go ahead and grab that crab stretcher. Check this out here. So we lock it onto the tack strip like that, and I use my knee to put some pressure at the front of it there. The reason I do this is when you push down on that handle, if you don't have enough pressure on the front, it'll just claw right across the carpet, pull the fibers out. It's all bad. You don't want to have that happen, because it can really end up costing you the job. But once you go ahead, watch this. See how I do that? Boom, it pulls all that pressure to the other end of the room for me. I take my kicker, boom, 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 lock it onto the tack strip. And with my left hand there, you see how I'm pushing down with my thumb. I am feeling for the nails in the tack strip there. And when I'm pushing down with my thumb, I'm making sure the nails are going into the carpet backing so that it's secured on nice and tight and it's not going anywhere on me. And we'll work my way all the way down the room here, just making sure the full length of the room is nice and tight and locked on that strip. And once I know we're good to go, we're gonna go ahead and crease the carpet onto the tack strip to ensure it's not going anywhere. I know this sounds so tedious, bear with me, we're almost at the finish line here. And then we're gonna go ahead and take our knife and our tuck knife, whether that be a 5-in-1, a stair tool, a hook knife, whatever the case, we're gonna tuck it in and make it look beautiful. So I'm at the other end here, let me finish out that wall. Boom, 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 good to go. Everything's nice and tight. Now it's time to get that final product going. And look at me, I'm just working my way around the room. I'm having so much fun, I don't wanna leave. Okay, let's get down to business here. Tuck this in and get our check. Now, if you're wondering what this service actually costs here, one doorway like this will run you a minimum stop charge. Depending upon where you're at, you're gonna pay about $75 to $100 to have that done. Now, you can see I just creased all that on. It's locked on nice and tight. Getting a fresh blade in my knife there. And I like to cut it into sections. And people always want to know why I don't use a wall trimmer. The reality of the story is I've purchased so many wall trimmers in my day, and my guys have always left them on job sites, that I made everybody just start trimming with their knives. It was like total whatever move I pulled on everybody back in the day, and it became lifestyle after that. Never went back to the wall trimmers. So are they effective? Yes. Should you have them? Without a doubt. Me, we all became accustomed to just trimming and tucking with a knife, and that was it. It was lifestyle after that, period. Never bought a wall trimmer again. Plus they're $65, and after you have to buy a bunch every single week, gets a little aggravating, and you never say, you know, I'm never gonna buy them again. So you just take your time, cut it about a quarter inch hefty up to that wood reducer there, take your hook knife and just push it down in there, get a nice clean finish, brush the fibers away with your hand as you work along to make sure everything's tucked down and whatever's loose is loose, it's gone, and everything else has a beautiful finish to it. But really, this is all there is to it. We can go ahead and finish out the video here, but you know the reality of this. If you have any questions about the carpet and flooring industry, you got to comment below. I'm going to create those follow-up videos answering whatever questions for you, because if you don't help me, I can't help you, and I'm just going to put out whatever nonsense comes to mind, and it may not get you what you need to get the result you want. So, thank you so much for tuning in. I always appreciate connecting with you. I'm going to see you on the next video.